Hello, everyone. We've heard about extraordinary use cases of data that are changing a life. Now I'm going to go deeper and talk about the technology. How do we do that? How do we bring this data to the consumption of use cases? And you were just saying that there are plenty of disconnected assets. And we want to connect those disconnected assets, the drones, the LiDAR, the cameras, the sensors of the world. So I'm going to talk to you about 5G and data. The story you're going to hear is a bit different from what you heard about 5G so far in the market. And there was one place where we could do a very disruptive approach of 5G. This is Dish. Dish is an entrepreneur company. It's in the US. The US has to be the leader of 5G because it's a software-driven and silicon-driven ecosystem. And the place where silicon and software grows is in the US. So we had to start from there. We started what we called a cloud-native 5G networks. Everybody else was telling us it cannot be done. Well, we didn't know that. So we did it, and actually we have done it. It's done, and it's working now. It's a nationwide, it's the fourth nationwide network in the US, and it's across the US now live. So what have we done? Well, actually, we looked at 5G differently. I had the privilege of being in the telco industry for three decades, and I know that 5G is not the same as before. This is not for humans. Unfortunately, everybody is selling 5G as a better smartphone. I guess most of you have a 5G smartphone, and I would guess nobody has seen the difference, right? Because it's not for humans. 5G was done for machines, for data. 4G, 3G, 2G were done for the speed of humans, for the reactions of humans. 5G, and I was part of the engineering of the specs of 5G for the last 10 years, was done for machines. So if you try to sell it as a 4G, please, doesn't work, and we've seen that across the world. Now, once you think different about 5G, then you approach it differently. The current networks, the ones you have in the US, you have three large networks, but it's the same in the rest of the world. They're built on 4G. This technology has been deployed for the last 15 years. It's obsolete, it's complex, it's locked in, it's frozen. And I'll give you two examples. I used to be at Nokia. I was managing the business network of Nokia. We saw WhatsApp coming. I had 1,200 engineers working on applications for messaging, and I saw WhatsApp coming, 32 engineers. Every week, we had a workforce to go against WhatsApp. We lost. Why did we lose? We had the best engineers. We lost because the networking is so complex in telco that we could not compete. I'll give you another example. The telco industry is a $2 trillion industry in the world. COVID comes. All of a sudden, the number one communication media becomes your computer and video conferencing. Guess what? The telco industry misses it 100%. The Teams, the WebEx, all these are over the top. Why? Because the telco industry could not react on time. By the time they started doing their application, it was taking 2 years. So we had to change that. So the way to think of a 5G modern network is top down. You have to start without telco. You have to start from the cloud, and that's what we did. And then you plug in the telco back into it. So you reinvent the networks from the use case of the machines, of the data, from the cloud. And this is what we've done. Everything we've done is in the cloud. And then you can start reimagining the way you're distributing the service. An API, full programmable, software-driven capability, much simplified. Impossible to do with a bottom-up legacy 4G plus network. Now, if you think of it, all of a sudden the connectivity is bringing you the power of data. So I'm not talking connectivity for humans. That's what we've done with smartphones, which is very successful. Each of us spends about 3 hours per day on a smartphone. That's way too much, but that's the way we act now. This is 4G. With 5G, this is about connectivity and data and machines, right? Once you do that, then you unfold completely the power of the enterprise. And each enterprise wants to have their own virtual network. When you go to an enterprise and you ask them what they want, actually they want to bring their analytics, their knowledge, their data to their assets. They want to pull the data up. But you know what? They don't care about the network. Nobody cares about the network. If you ask them, how do you get your data? Is it Wi-Fi, 4G, 5G? Is it LoRa? Is it? Most people don't have a clue. They don't care. It's transport. That's our job, to take care of that in a very transparent manner so that your engineers can have access to the data they need and then develop the new services. And that's what we do with Palantir. We bring the data to the usage of the applications and the consumers. So think about a vision where you meet the data where it is. You don't have to worry about connectivity. You don't have to worry about subscriptions. You don't have to worry about SIM cards, about modems. You just discover and have access to your data. You have a drone, you connect to your drone. Who knows how you connect? Doesn't matter. We take care of that, right? Today, when you connect to the internet, you don't know where the traffic is going, and nobody cares. It has to be the same with wireless. Once you overcome all these challenges, then you can start developing a lot of new applications that we have seen before, because the requirement and the needs from the industries are massive. So the picture I want to leave with you is that this is not about 4G plus. So relax. The fact that you don't see why your phone is doing 5G, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Relax. 4G is good. 5G is good. Doesn't make any difference. But it makes difference for machines. And it has to be global. If you're servicing, most of you have global businesses, you don't want to know which network you use, which coverage, which SIM cards. You just want to access all your subscribers. So the way we're developing a network, actually, is that we have partnerships with our friends from T-Mobile, AT&T. So when you lock on our network, you have the coverage of all of us. And why would you know? I mean, it's just mobility, right? You can do roaming inside, outside the US, nobody cares. This is, again, not 4G plus. Now, think about this $2 trillion industry. On the left, you have the stage of where we are. Best effort quality. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. Well, coverage holds, drop calls, and SIM management, SIM cards. The way we're moving into the next generation of networks is a full enterprise control network, where you control your policy. Where do you put your traffic? When do you upload? When do you upgrade your devices? You decide based on your cost, your emergency, your requirements. Traffic steering, security, your own security. Identity management. Why would you have SIM card identity management? Nobody uses that anywhere else. We all use mails, passwords, certificates. That has to be managed by the enterprise, not by the carrier. Data control. Who wants to expose their data to the cloud? Nobody does. Everybody has to be able to control where they put their data, right? And then an open ecosystem. There are tons of devices that need to be connected, and it should not depend on the certification of one or two carriers. So the way to think of it is your data, your network, right? Your ontology. And then you decide, not the carrier, how you move your data. Or you combine your data, or you share your data. You decide, you control. Your CIOs are in control. And how are they in control? Well, through APIs, and I'm going to show you that. But before I show you that, let me talk about what we did for ourselves at Dish. We were lucky that based on our FCC requirements, we had to deploy a nationwide network. So we just built it. So we're building at a rhythm of about 1,000 sites per month, and each site is a data center. So we have actually built in the US the largest in the world edge cloud of the world, where we have thousands and thousands of data centers across the US. And once we understood that we were building the largest distributed edge, we had to start managing data for ourselves. Observability, manage our mini data centers, understand all the traffic, the flows. So we built this connected observability for ourselves. And now we're saying, well, actually, this is exactly the same everybody, every enterprise needs. They need to connect to their edge. Our edge happens to be a 5G tower. Your edge could be a drone. It could be a robot. It could be a video surveillance camera. But this is the same we have built for ourselves. So how do you expose that as a consumption, simple consumption service? Well, you have to think developers first. All of you are working with your own developers, and they are thinking about the applications. These people want simple connectivity. They don't care. They don't want to have to waste time. So our job, together with Palantir, is to expose connectivity as a simple API. So think about emergency dispatcher, right? He has to connect a drone with an ambulance. Does he need to know he has a VPN, a certification? And no, he wants to connect a 4K camera to the ambulance. Click, click, that's it. That's an API. That's the way to think of it, right? And he doesn't care how we do it, as long as he knows he has his feed that is secured, that has the right quality. And he does it for 1 hour, 20 minutes, and then done, right? That's the way we think. So one of the, I'm sure you have seen such diagrams. The way we expose it is by different modules. Like you go, think of AWS Cloud or Azure. You take all these APIs, you know, those black boxes, and you start putting them together as a Lego. That's your service. So your service, again, with your dispatcher, emergency dispatcher, could be, I monitor the ambulance availability. I monitor where it is, its location. So I want to have the location of my device. I want to know if my devices inside the ambulance, they still have battery. I want to understand if there is congestion or if the 911 has full priority. I want to see this with simple clicks. This is what it depicts. So you have connectivity, you have analytics, you have visibility, and then you can start correlating that data for all those emergencies or applications you have in the field. So that's a use case that one of our customers has been developing, I mean, just by connecting all those bricks that we expose. So you don't see any SIM cards, you don't see any complex negotiations or what, you just click like you go into AWS or Azure. So as a result, for business people that have their retail, car, logistics business, what they see is just a way of connecting all their applications. But 5G disappears. They don't know if it's 5G, Wi-Fi 6, 7, satellite. They don't know if we're roaming on T-Mobile or AT&T or if we have our own towers. Who cares? As long as you have all those capabilities that are meshed together, and that's our job to do it. And that's our job, to take the complexity out of the hands of your developers and CIOs, because they don't have the time to do that, right? What they should focus instead is on the marketplace, on the top of the pyramid. And they should let us do the heavy duty, boring work of the engineering of the technology, which is data, connectivity, security, so that they can meet the data where it is. And then they can consume their data, which is their job. We understand nothing about the analytics of all those different domains, but what we understand is the connectivity, the exposure, at the speed of the machines, not at the speed of humans, and at the scale of machines. And that's what we've built in the US, that's what is life now, and that's what we're starting to expose together with Palantir. Thank you.